The number one thing that keeps me up at night on regulatory issues that face our company and the industry, the first one is financial assurance. That's the one that could, from one day to the next, if the rules change there, put a lot of companies out of business. You know, we as a company with three operations in the U.S. have $200 million of surety bonds in place to make sure that if we're not around to properly close and reclaim and remediate these sites, that there's sufficient funding there to do that. To put another whole layer on top of that of duplicative funding requirements, and if there's a need to then cash collateralize any of those obligations, the liquidity requirements that would draw out of companies would tip a lot of companies over into insolvency. The surety bonding companies that are out there now, from whom we have these surety bonds in place, is a shrinking pool. Not a lot of companies want to be in that business. So there are fewer and fewer sources to go to procure these surety bonds to cover that end of life, end of mine life obligation. If they see some other set of rules coming in, I think those last few guys are going to head for the sidelines and get out of this business line altogether. They watch our financial statements as close as any investor. They're mostly focused on liquidity and just the overall balance sheet health of the company. We are making financing decisions now based on the surety bonding risk and the risk of additional financial assurance requirements coming from the EPA. It's one of those icebergs where everything is, you know, kind of under the surface of the water that most investors, most analysts that cover us as a public company don't appreciate. But it's one of those risks that if we aren't out ahead of it, it's a company killer.
When you look at the regulatory environment, I think the key for me is having certainty over a time frame. You're going to make an investment. You want to know that you'll be able to pay that investment off. So changing the rules while things are underway isn't a good way to get to an end point. I think if you want to change those rules, you work through, identify what you're trying to get to, and then lay out a logical program to get from where you're at to there over a time frame for implementation. So I get tightening regulations and requirements. You got to make sure they're making sense, that they don't duplicate what's already in there, what the state's responsible for versus what the federal government is responsible for, and getting that straight is really important. So I think it's always evolving. It's political by its nature and how things get decided, but where I can help as the CEO is come and just tell people the facts as I see them, and try to not to influence, but to make sure that those people who make these decisions really do understand they have a big impact, not just on our business, but to the communities, the people that work for us. That has a big impact, and we don't want them making bad decisions based on poor information.
The idea of it's flawed from the get-go, in the sense that we have existing requirements and financial assurance for the reclamation of mines. What's even more troubling is when you look at how they plan to do the calculation of the financial assurance, it creates such a big liability that you have to have on top of what we're already having to bond for, that what it's really going to do is it's going to cause mines that we could develop, and you know, we've been around 125 years, you know, we've been able to close down mines, and in fact we probably have closed down and reclaimed probably more mines than just about any other company in the U.S. But if you had this financial assurance, this additional layer of financial assurance, we wouldn't have been able to do that. So that's very, very troubling that this is being imposed, and it's very troubling that there is no connection to the reality of what we're already having to do, nor the cost of what they are contemplating.